Good evening. I'm Kathy Michaelby.
And I'm Toya Washington. What might have been an attempt to prevent flooding is being blamed for leaving a huge mess in several Whitefish Bay basements.
And 12 News' Mike Anderson is live tonight at the corner of Woodruff and Fairmount. And Mike, this was no accident.
No, it wasn't, Kathy. What you see behind me right now going on is a lot of construction activity, cement trucks rolling in and out. You'd never know that flooding was an issue here last Friday, but indeed it was, caused by someone who was trying to divert stormwater and subsequent sewage backup from that person's area to someone else's.
The village says last Friday's flooding and backup was beyond its control. In fact, officials say it was criminal. The engineer says investigators have evidence that someone physically removed a manhole cover at Fairmount and Cumberland.
Why would anyone do this?
To relieve a local runoff problem where they may have seen or had perceived that there was going to be some flooding in their area.
The village at this point has no clue who did it and is not planning to go after any suspects. It has no place to start short of a witness or a confession. Meanwhile, residents are angry and confused. Some Whitefish Bay residents staged a small protest this morning, angry over the way the summer has gone. There was a ball of confusion as Assistant Village Engineer Aaron Yankee tried to explain why they had sewer backup in their basements for the third time this summer after a hard rain. One resident is about to lose her insurance after this most recent sewer backup Friday night.
Our insurance company called Saturday, and she's concerned that we're going to be dropped. We won't have homeowners insurance because we've had three claims now in 5 weeks. You can't blame them for dropping us.
Basically, residents say the engineers and village officials are either avoiding them, being untruthful, just don't know what to tell them, or all of the above.
Can't go on summer vacation because you're afraid it's going to rain. I mean, we have to stand by, actually, and man the pumps, basically, because that's our only, you know, avenue.
The village, they have done nothing.
We can only empathize with what people are going through.
Not much else they can do right now, but they are, the city officials say, or village officials say, they are consulting with consultants about what to do about the long-range flooding problem here. But some residents say they've had enough already. They are starting to take matters into their own hands. Live in Whitefish Bay, Mike Anderson, WISN 12 News.